Despite all our technological advancements, our scientific achievements, the weather is still something that we can neither properly predict nor control. Powerful hurricanes still devastate our sprawling cities, rough seas still sink our mighty ships, and strong microbursts and wind shears still, to this day, can bring down our aircraft in seconds.
Breaking out on a passenger plane.
Long hours affecting thousands of passengers.
A brand new plane lost their lives.
Comes after the chaos we saw overnight at the Fort Lauderdale.
Although we've learned to deal with the weather, the frequency of accidents attributed to it has gone down. The approach we have used to achieve this reduction has been running away from the problem instead of facing it head on. Avoiding these weather phenomena forces flights to stay airborne, remain grounded, or even divert to a nearby airport, causing losses to both stuck passengers and the airlines operating these aircraft. This is seemingly unavoidable, primarily due to a quirk in how the jet engines function. When pilots request a particular throttle setting, the engines don't immediately respond to the change. There's a delay, sometimes lasting even 7 seconds or more, before the engines attain the required thrust setting, which makes it incredibly hard to recover from microbursts and wind shears. Sometimes, it's not possible to escape a microburst even at full thrust. If this delay can be overcome, and if the thrust of modern jet engine can be temporarily increased, the risk associated with flying in the presence of these phenomena will be eliminated. Enthuse works to overcome these problems by providing aircraft with near-instant thrust in precipitating conditions, thus allowing them to easily recover from the aforementioned phenomena. The system works by first collecting water into a circular tank inside the bypass duct of the engine, called the water electrolyzation tank, or WET for short. Once a sufficient amount of water has been collected, the tank is closed and the electrodes inside the tank are supplied with power, splitting the water into hydrogen and oxygen gas. This gas can then be supplied into the engine nozzle, where it will burn, raising the temperature and exhaust velocity of the mixture existing in the engine, and thus increasing thrust. As the additional thrust is added after the turbine stage, it does not suffer from temperature and spin limitations that usually cap engine performance. It is thus able to provide more thrust more responsively. Due to the nature of how Enthuse tackles the problem, there are no direct competitors that it faces. However, weather radars, windshear detection systems and the like also address the issue, and so are competing against us in the safety aspect, if not the economical one. These systems only help avoid the problem, and are prone to false alarms, only exacerbating the delays that Enthuse is aiming to reduce. Other operationally similar systems like afterburners and water injection systems aren't used on commercial aircraft, since they have several issues, chief among them being the cost of operation. Our intellectual property will be sold to aircraft and engine manufacturers, a booming market which has seen tremendous growth. We will approach angel investors, aircraft and engine manufacturers, the airline and cargo industry, and the government for schemes, loans and other funds.